If you were my son or my daughter, this is what I would have to say to you. If you were my son or my daughter, what I would have to tell you, what I would have to say. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. Well, I don't give advice. I don't give suggestions. I just share with you my opinions, my viewpoints, and how I see life. And I don't give information, so I just show you how I live my life and what I think on different topics, okay? If you haven't liked, shared, subscribed to all five of my channels, links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me with all five channels, I will likely connect back with you as well. From my house to yours. Well, I got to thinking today, and this is the topic I got to thinking about. If you were my son or daughter, what would I have to tell you? Well, there's a lot more than just one video can cover, but some of the things I would tell you is think highly of yourself, think highly of your goals, have dreams, have visions, have plans, and have action plans that are the right action plans for your life. Be selective about your choices. Remember, your choices and decisions can determine the outcome of your life. Yes, there are unpredictable factors in life, but some of those unpredictable factors are good things as well. There are opportunities that can come by. Don't settle for less than what you want in life unless you have to, and usually you don't have to in life. Don't let loneliness dictate what relationships you choose, because often when we let loneliness dictate our relationships, often what can happen is we will choose the wrong relationships. Invest in yourself. Invest in yourself. Keep your standards high, not just for yourself, but for those that enter into your life and that you have relationships for. Don't reduce yourself down to their standards. Have them live up to your standards and expectations. If you were my son or daughter, I would say never, ever, ever let someone mistreat you or treat you wrong. Make sure that people treat you with respect. Make sure they honor you in the sense that you should be honored, and be respectful to other people. Be respectful to your parents who have blessed your life. Be respectful to them always. And remember, they have given you this opportunity to live the life that you're living. And so remember that. Always honor your parents and be good to them. And if someone speaks bad about your parents, usually that's a relationship that I would say to avoid. Okay? Because when someone speaks bad about your parents, they're likely going to continue that, and they want to manipulate you and control you in some way and pull you away from the people that love you. Okay? And so what else would I tell you if you were my son or daughter? Well, like I said, I would say invest in yourself, invest in your education. Always be learning. Take care of your body. Take care of your health. Take care of your finances. And remember, not everyone is trustworthy. Many people are not. Some people will come to you with a smile, and yet they're there to do things or take from you in a way that's not to your benefit. Remember, let other people be good to you too while you're being good to them. Not everyone belongs in your life, okay? Not everyone belongs in your life up close and personal. When it comes time for a partner or a romantic relationship or marriage, make sure that it's the right one. I don't believe in casual dating, because I think in casual dating, often we can get pulled into relationships longer term that can turn into very long term that are not right for our lives. I believe in selective dating, being very selective, keeping our standards high, even if that means waiting on the right person. I would rather wait a lifetime for the right person than settle for the wrong person in life. And so there are so many things that I could say if you were my son or you were my daughter. Like I said, I don't give advice or I don't give suggestions, but hold your standards up high. Take care of you. No one wants to invest in someone that's not investing in themselves. Stay focused on you. Remember, you deserve to be treated well, and yet you need to treat other people well and with respect as well. And remember your parents always, as I said, because those are your guiding force in life. And remember, I always say honor God, because God is number one. And anyone that, to me, that doesn't honor God, well, you know, that's their right and that's their choice and that's their belief. And yet I personally would want people that believe in God and that believe in the higher power and that believe that there is right and that there is wrong. People who simply believe that everything is gray, usually that is not the right way for me, okay? So if you were my son or daughter, I would say enjoy your life. Life is meant to be enjoyed. Life is meant to be happy. There will be ups and there will be downs. There will be challenging times, but you can get through those challenging times. Remember, you just have to hang in there. You just have to stick in there. And you know, the thing is, no one can inspire you but yourself. You have to inspire yourself. Yes, you can be around people that can be inspiring, and that's a great thing. The people that you choose to hang out with will affect your life. The friends that you choose will affect your life. So choose your friends wisely, choose your relationships wisely, and most certainly choose your romantic partner wisely, because that person can shape or change your life in the best of ways or the worst of ways. So you want it to be the best of ways. You want to choose the right partner. And remember, always to love yourself. Okay. Well, there's so much more that I would say to you if you were my son and my daughter, but I can't think of all of it right now, and I don't have my notes in front of me. And even if I did, I would probably have to make many, many videos, because there's a lot to talk about. So may God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all 5 channels, and I hope to talk to you soon again. And so from Grandma's porch to wherever you're at, I hope to talk to you then. Bye-bye. To relax.